Good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I am Smriti Rastogi. Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa passed away 26 years ago on May 15, 1993. He was the first Commander-in-Chief of the Indian Army. By any standards or description, Field Marshal Karyappa was a remarkable man. To him fell the task of laying the foundation of the modern Indian Army. He was the man in charge of the nation's fighting force that thwarted the first attacks from across the border on independent India. As the first Indian Commander-in-Chief of the Indian Army, Karyappa led the Indian forces on the Western Front during the Indo-Pakistan War of 1947. K.M. Karyappa was appointed as the first Commander-in-Chief of an independent Indian Army on 15th January 1949. The day is celebrated as Army Day. Karyappa was made India's first field marshal after a distinguished military career that spanned almost three decades. Today, in In-Depth, we revisit the life and legacy of Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa, the many contours of his personality that endeared him to his troops, his commitment to the nation that always made him insist on putting India first, and the efforts he undertook to make Indian Army the professional outfit that it is today. One of the country's most exceptional military commanders, Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa, will always be remembered as a legend instrumental in the formation of the Indian Armed Forces. Field Marshal Karyappa, a man known for many firsts, took charge of the Indian Army from its last British Commander-in-Chief, General Sir Roy Boucher, in 1949. Karyappa was conferred the rank of Field Marshal on 28th April 1986, an honorary five-star rank of the Indian Army.
Born on January 28, 1899, Kodandera Kippur Madappa Karyappa was one of six children. His father was an official in the British Colonial Administration of India. In 1917, he completed his formal education at Madikeri town in Karnataka. Chimma, as Karyappa was called by his family and close friends, went on to study at the Presidency College in Madras. In college, after learning that Indians are being recruited into the army as officers and were to be trained in India, Karyappa was one of the 70 applicants to apply at the Delhi Cadet College in Indore. He was one of 42 to finally get admission into the training program.
Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa, he was the first commanding, he was the first to command a battalion, he was the first to command Indian officer to command a brigade, and he was also the first Indian commander in chief of the Indian armed forces, that all the three forces or three services combined. So that is who K.M. Karyappa was.
Karyappa joined the British Indian Army in 1919 and was commissioned in the 88th Carnatic Infantry at Bombay as temporary second lieutenant. He was granted permanent commission on September 9, 1922 and promoted to the rank of captain in 1927. Karyappa was appointed Deputy Assistant Quartermaster General or DAQMG in 1931. In March 1936, he was appointed Staff Captain of the Deccan area. 2 years later, in 1938, Karyappa was promoted to Major and appointed Deputy Assistant Adjutant and Quartermaster General. In 1941-42, during the Second World War, Karyappa actively served in Iraq, Iran and Syria and then in Burma in 1943-44. In 1942, he was given command of an army unit, becoming the first Indian officer to have British officers serving under him. For his services in the Butidong operation in Burma, Karyappa was awarded the Order of the British Empire in June 1945. In the same year, Karyappa was made the commander of the Bannu Frontier Brigade in Waziristan. During this period, Colonel Ayub Khan, who went on to become the President of Pakistan, served under him. In November 1947, Karyappa was appointed Eastern Army Commander after being promoted to Lieutenant General. As the situation worsened in Kashmir in 1947, Karyappa was moved as General Officer Commanding in Chief, Western Command, where he directed operations for the recapture of territories seized by Afghan tribals backed by Pakistani Army. On January 5, 1949, Karyappa took over the reins of the Indian Army, the day which is now celebrated in India as Army Day. Karyappa took charge of the Indian Army from Sir Roy Butcher and thereafter laid the foundation of the modern Indian Army. Karyappa, whose military career spanned over three decades, retired from the Army in 1953 and later served as the High Commissioner to Australia and New Zealand till 1956. In 1986, he was awarded the five-star rank of Field Marshal, the highest honour in the Indian Army. The title has been conferred only twice so far, on Karyappa and before him on Sam Manekshaw in 1973.
See, the rank of Field Marshal has been given very rarely. Like I will recall just two people, that is Field Marshal Karyappa and Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw in the Indian Army. Air Marshal Arjun Singh, Marshal of the Indian Air Force, was the other five-star officer. So this is given very rarely, it is like an honor. So this means this officer who is five-star rank wears his uniform, ceremonial uniform, till he is alive. He is counted on the rolls of the army till he is alive. So there have been three people who have been given this rank.
In 1951, then US President Harry Truman conferred on him the Order of the Chief Commander of the Legion of Merit, the first ever award of its kind given to an Indian general for his efforts in improving Indo-US relations. Field Marshal Karyappa passed away on May 15, 1993 at the age of 93. With input from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
After independence, K.M. Karyappa took over the reins of the Indian Army from Roy Butcher in 1949 and laid the foundation of modern Indian Army, the day which is now celebrated in India as the Army Day. Apart from being the first Commander-in-Chief of the Indian Army, K.M. Karyappa is also known for several other firsts. So here's the fascinating story of Karyappa, a man who would invariably occupy the top spot if one were to count the most distinguished soldiers of India.
K.M. Karyappa is a man known for many firsts, but he is best remembered as the legend who made the Indian Army truly Indian. After independence, K.M. Karyappa took over the reins of the Indian Army from British General Roy Butcher in 1949 and laid the foundation of the modern Indian Army. He was the first Indian Commander-in-Chief of the country's armed forces. This meant that General Karyappa was the supreme commander of the Indian military, that included the Indian Air Force and the Indian Navy. He was instrumental in forming the Brigade of Guards, the Parachute Regiment and the Territorial Army. Though the National Cadet Corps had been already raised in 1948, it was Karyappa who strengthened and supported it during its formative years. All these branches of the Indian Army would prove to be of great value during the wars India fought in the later years. While Karyappa refused to induct former INA personnel into the army to maintain its autonomy and distance from political affairs, he did adopt INA's slogan Jai Hind as the formal phrase of greeting between army personnel. He also rejected the proposal for caste-based reservation in the army. He attempted to do away with caste, creed and other barriers in the Indian Army by raising the Brigade of the Guards. Field Marshal Karyappa was a strong advocate of building up India's industrial capacity in order to support the country's military.
First Indian to head the Indian Army. His biggest task was removing it from the British traditions to Indianize the Indian Army. Now during that time, the Indian Army Act 1950 also came up, which lays down the rules of engagement and also the rules for the Indian Army to function. That was his biggest gift to the Indian Army, to Indianize the Indian Army. Because the Indian Army, as we all know, was set up by the British, its regiments, its cultures and everything was that. Karyappa sir also had a very important role. He refused to give any reservations in Indian Army. He said there will be no reservation in Indian Army. Till date, The officer class of the Indian Army is open to all categories. You can apply. If you pass the test, you are in. And if you pass the physicals, you are in. However, in case of the regiments, they function as they were during the British times.
K.M. Kariappa was always known to lead by example. A tireless worker whose hobbies included reading and playing sports, Kariappa always led from the front and by personal example. A strong believer in personal communication, he would make it a point to spend time with his troops to ask them about their food, their comfort. Soldiers who served under him also remembered him motivating them frequently.
Legacy, he was the most principled officer who was stickler of rules, and he did value very much the soldier's way of functioning, and he did also respect all his juniors of whatever rank he might be, and his personal conduct was above board.
Kariappa finally retired in 1953 after a long and illustrious career. As the Indian High Commissioner to Australia and New Zealand, Kariappa was impressed by the methods employed by the Australian government to help its former servicemen and brought them to the notice of the Indian government. His recommendations were soon adopted. Despite advancing age, Kariappa made many visits to the armed forces on the frontiers to boost their morale during the Indo-Pak Wars in 1965 and 1971.
He took many important decisions, and one of that was that he even treated the prisoners of the Indian National Army very well, which perhaps the Britishers didn't want to, even though the Britishers had gone, but there were still some British elements. So therefore, to that extent, that was a good decision. And even before that, he had taken part in many committees and conferences regarding what should be done about the post-independent Indian Army, its organization, its structures.
After taking over as the 27th Chief of Army Staff in 2017, General Bipin Rawat said, a great deal of credit goes to General Kariappa for making the Indian Army truly Indian. He said that today, the nation can take pride in the role played by the Army in guarding it against external threats and insurgency promoted by hostile elements. General Bipin Rawat also said Kariappa deserved the Bharat Ratna, the country's highest civilian award. Interestingly, till date, no military person has ever been awarded the Bharat Ratna, India's highest civilian award that is awarded in any field of human endeavor. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And with that, we'll slip into a very quick break. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira, at 6:30 p.m.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Delhi's rich history and heritage is also a story of monuments marking the beginning of eras and kingdoms. One of the oldest such monuments is Qutb Minar, which marks the establishment of Delhi Sultanate. Qutb Minar was commissioned by Qutbuddin Aibak, who laid the foundation of Mamluk dynasty rule in India. Nearly 73 meters to 40 feet high, this tower is built on the pattern of Victory Tower at Ghazni. It remains to this day one of the most spectacular buildings in India, dating to medieval era. The red sandstone minaret is divided into five stories, each of which has a balcony. The view from its top, now rare, once overlooked the old walls and the ruins spread over the vast expanse of plains in Delhi. While the construction began in 1192 AD, Qutbuddin Aibak didn't live long enough to see it completed. The Minar was eventually completed in 1220 by his successor, Iltutmish.
Welcome back. Field Marshal Kariyappa made sure that the Indian Army and politics do not cross each other. It is because of him that the Indian Army has become a highly professional force and is credited for its valor across the world. There are many instances that have made Field Marshal a remarkable personality and a towering figure in the Indian military. Let's take a look at some of the most memorable moments from his incredible career.
There are many factors that make Field Marshal K.M. Kariyappa a towering figure in the history of Indian military. All of them are relevant and important to this day. Appointed as Deputy Chief of General Staff, K.M. Kariyappa was later made General Officer Command in charge of East Punjab Command in 1947 after the situation in Kashmir became worse. Kariyappa renamed it as Western Command, moved the headquarters to Jammu and raised a core headquarters under Lieutenant General S.M. Sri Ganesh at Udhampur. He also appointed Lieutenant General K.S. Timaiya as the GOC for Jammu and Kashmir and Atma Singh as GOC for Jammu Division. Kariyappa led the Indian forces on the Western Front during the India-Pakistan War of 1947. He launched three operations, Kipper, Easy and Bison, to capture the Nowshera, Poonch, Zozila, Dras and Kargil areas. Kariyappa managed to push back Pakistani forces and was actually on the verge of driving them out of the valley. However, it was not carried out due to Jawaharlal Nehru's intervention after the issue was taken up by the United Nations. Disregarding orders, Kariyappa launched strikes in the Ladakh area and allowed India to take control of that region. In doing so, Kariyappa became instrumental in recapturing Zozila, Dras and Kargil and also managed to create a link-up with Leh before the then Indian government decided to abide by a United Nations brokered ceasefire on January 1, 1949. After retirement, Field Marshal Kariyappa said he was sure of the fact that the army was quite confident of clearing Kashmir, but the orders was to cease fire midnight 31st December, 1st January 1948-49. Apart from a distinguished career in the Indian Army, Field Marshal Kariyappa's iron will and love for his troops was on display during the 1965 Indo-Pak War. It was the last day of the war when the 36-year-old son of the Field Marshal's squadron leader K.C. Kariyappa was flying near the border and was shot down. Squadron leader K.C. Kariyappa was taken prisoner by the Pakistani army. At that time, General Ayub Khan was the military ruler of Pakistan and he had served under Field Marshal K.M. Kariyappa in the British Indian Army. Ayub Khan immediately offered to release K.C. Kariyappa because he was Field Marshal Kariyappa's son. But the field marshal made it clear to Khan that his son was not to be given any special treatment. He told Ayub Khan that all captured Indian soldiers were his sons and all of them should be looked after well by Pakistan.
No, Ayub Khan has served as a colonel under when he was a brigade commander in now what is called Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. So Ayub knew him very well because he was his brigade commander. And during this incident in 1965, when his son KC Karyapa, he was shot down and made a prisoner. Then later on, Ayub, to show his goodwill gesture, had offered the Field Marshal Karyapa that he could return his son on a priority basis. But like the officer he was, Field Marshal Karyapa said, no, he's just like my, other prisoners, they are also my sons. So he did not seek any favors or privileges, and therefore he didn't want any kind of favor. And his son returned along with other prisoners.
Field Marshal Karyapa was not only instrumental in drawing the line between the Indian Army and politics, but he also helped shape the Army into a highly professional force right from its formative stages. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And with that, it's a wrap on this edition of In Depth. We will be back same time tomorrow with a focus on some other subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter. And don't forget to send your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for your time.